Hi, Ben Constable with you from Spark Systems. Today I'll demonstrate the new collaboration platform for Enterprise Architect, the Pro Cloud Server. But first, why do you want to add this important collaboration tool to your modeling solution? What challenges does the Pro Cloud Server help you to address? Remember, a key benefit of the models you create in Enterprise Architect is they facilitate communication both within your project team and with external stakeholders such as clients. So Enterprise Architect provides a range of ways to share your model content by means of reports, a free read-only model viewer, and team-based model repositories, to name a few. But with today's mobile and distributed development teams, you often want colleagues, clients, or subject matter experts to have a live view of the model wherever they are in the world, and that may be without any kind of desktop environment at their disposal. And in the case of project clients, they may have little to no modeling experience at all, so throwing an Enterprise Architect installer in their direction won't always work. So how can you engage these stakeholders via the model if all they have is a mobile phone or tablet in their hand? Well, that's exactly why we've made the Pro Cloud Server. As a separately licensed server-based product for EA, the Pro Cloud Server enables model-based collaboration for web and mobile users. It provides a web interface, WebEA, that renders an interactive model from a shared repository with the user requiring only a web browser and an internet connection. So I'll demonstrate three scenarios where the Pro Cloud Server can keep your distributed team members and clients engaged with or even contributing to your shared model. First, you need to deliver a presentation based on the model, with little advance notice. Next, you're gathering feedback from clients on your requirements model. And third, you're reviewing the project model in transit and need to make some quick updates. So consider your first challenge of a boardroom presentation, perhaps based on your business process model. No time to really prepare the presentation or generate pretty documents. Straight into the boardroom with only a projector and web browser, maybe on your phone. What will you do? In this kind of scenario, the WebEA component of the Pro Cloud Server really shines. Here it is in my browser now. You see I'm pointing to an address, which could be within a private corporate network, or as in this case, a publicly available domain. The Pro Cloud Server handles the request and lists all of the Enterprise Architect models I have available on this server, only two in this case. So I select the model I want to present, and then click Next to log in. So here I'm using EA's role-based security to log into the model, so I'll be identified as a particular user with certain editing privileges. After logging in, WebEA's main view displays your startup diagram if you've set one like I have here. In the top right of the screen, I have controls to show where I am in the project hierarchy, my browsing history, and some other features we'll use later. Remember, we're about to use this as a presentation platform in a meeting, so I'll go to full screen to minimize distractions. Well, let's review that business process model. And I like to use high-level diagrams like this one in EA to help navigate the model. So you're looking at an Enterprise Architect diagram here that serves as a launchpad into the main branches of the model. If you are going to present from EA directly, it's a handy kind of diagram to build up as you go. So I click the business modeling link here. That drills down into the set of analysis and business process models. Under BPMN2, let's present the process model for the book lending example. So you can quickly drill down to the model of interest and really present your process model directly from screen. And remember, this is a live feed, not a set of static pages generated from a snapshot of the model. So if you've just been putting some finishing touches on the model before heading into the presentation room, that's all going to show up just as you saw it when you edited the model last. You'll notice each of these process elements are interactive in the sense that I can click on them and drill down into their properties. So the element's project-related properties are listed here, all of its relationships, the tagged values, and others. Also, if there's any feedback from your colleagues that comes out of your presentation, well, you can note that immediately against the relevant elements in the discussion field like this. And this raises another collaboration feature that the Pro Cloud Server enables for external stakeholders such as clients. Let's delve into our second scenario. There are times when you want to give external stakeholders limited access to your model, perhaps for review purposes. Well, as you've seen, the WebEA component of the Pro Cloud Server already gives you an interactive live feed in an easy-to-navigate environment. You could make that model content publicly available to even a large community of reviewers. But you also want an option for your remote audience to submit feedback or directly annotate the model as they're reviewing it. Think of project clients validating your requirements model, or a subject matter expert reviewing your information model, checking for correct or missing domain objects. Do you really want their valuable input buried within annotations inside a static document? Wouldn't it be better if they could add comments directly to the model artifacts they're reviewing? Yes, WebEA gives you the element discussion capability to do exactly that. Let's consider a scenario in which your clients review the requirements model and provide feedback that you need to incorporate. How does the ProCloud server empower you in this situation? As a project client now, I'm visiting that same web address for the team's ProCloud server. So the project team has given me a username and password for a role that doesn't have model editing privileges as such, but can add discussions. So I log in. And this is just the same model you saw before, but now I have restricted access, only able to view elements and add discussion threads. So I'll drill down to the requirements model and review the user stories for the bookstore project. Clicking on the linked requirement there, I'll view its description. And as the project client, this requirement's description doesn't match my expectation. I want to be able to list stock specifically by author, title, and genre. So I'll start a discussion about this. And now subsequent comments can be posted by the project team under that discussion thread. So how would this appear for the project team who is actually authoring the model in Enterprise Architect desktop environment? Well, here's the model as it appears in the desktop installation of Enterprise Architect. It's using the same ProCloud server to fetch the model, so as you'd expect, the same diagrams are present. But the full model tree is represented here in the project browser, and I have the rich array of editing tools available in the desktop client. Now in the desktop installation, I used the cloud connection option just here to access this cloud model. So this is the environment that most of your team members will use to create and edit the model. But using the ProCloud server, we have the added advantage of gathering that web-based input. So here's the requirement that the customer commented on, and I can see their suggestion in the element discussion view. So there's their comment. Let's make the appropriate change to the requirement description over in the notes view. Okay, and now we'll let them know that we've updated the definition based on their feedback. So bring back the discussion view. And post a reply. Back in the web view, the client sees my response when they next load or refresh that page, or when they access it through their watch list. Just up here. So they can just click on the recent discussions, see the requirement they've commented on, and there's the reply. Now I'll show you briefly how you set up such a reviewer type role as we've done here for project clients. In Enterprise Architect's desktop environment, I access the security users function from the configure ribbon. And see, I've created a user here named Client A. Well, you can create as many of those as you need, one for each of your named clients. And just make sure that the model editing privileges are cleared in the list of user permissions over on the right here. Then give the client your login and password, point them to the web address for your ProCloud server, and that's it. Until now, we've used the WebEA component of the ProCloud server to view the model, but haven't really edited any model elements. So consider the third scenario I raised, in which you need to make some quick updates to the model in transit, perhaps after having met with the project client. So you want to make the model updates while they're fresh in mind. So again, you may only have your mobile device at hand in this scenario. So I logged into my shared model via WebEA, this time as a team member with editing rights. I'll navigate to the requirements model using the hierarchy here to list the contents of the requirements package. And notice here I have an option to add new elements. So during a meeting with a client, I can quickly contribute to the project model even from the browser on my phone. So say for example we have a new functional requirement to report on inventory. So I select an element type of requirement and type in a name for that requirement. And then I'll just paste in a rough requirements definition here, click add, and you'll see from the message the requirement has been successfully added. So as I go back to list the requirements package, you can see it included here. But I can also edit any existing elements to make updates as well. For example, if I open up that requirement I just made, I can update the requirements definition by clicking that edit icon. But you also have access to such things as project tasks, issue tracking, and defects as well. Say, for example, I want to assign my task associated with this new requirement. So I just click Add Task, and here's everything you need. So give the task a name, then assign a status. Finally, click Add to enter the task. So going back to the requirement, we'll see that that task has been listed along with a set of tasks for the requirement here. So while WebEA doesn't provide the full rich modeling environment that you have in a desktop installation, it does provide useful, lightweight editing for mobile users so they can contribute to the project anywhere at any time. So today I've shown how the WebEA component of the new ProCloud server really empowers your team-based modeling projects by helping you to access and present the model content from your mobile device, allowing clients and other stakeholders to also view the model and even contribute their comments directly into the model repository, and by empowering mobile project team members with a lightweight editing interface to update the model directly from a handheld device without requiring an enterprise architect installation. Today, we've only covered part of what the new ProCloud server offers. Besides WebEA, there's support for row-level locking to protect sensitive aspects of the model, a new enterprise license management capability, among others. And these are subjects for future presentations. For more information about the ProCloud server, please visit our webpage, sparksystems.com/ProCloud. If you'd like to actually try the ProCloud server and see it in action, you can visit the same URL I used in this presentation, demo.sparkspublic.com. Then choose the EA example model and log in with a password of demo. That'll give you read-only access to browse the model contents, so you can try that on a phone or a tablet or even a web browser on a PC. If you're keen to experiment with the discussion capability and model editing, for a limited time, you can write to us at webinar@sparksystems.com and request a demo model with editing privileges as well. Of course, we always welcome your feedback, so let us know your thoughts. I hope you found this introduction useful. Until next time, happy modeling.